Welcome to my class, student. It's class 8, English Honeydew. We are doing chapter 4, that is Vipin Chaudhary's Lapse of Memory, and this is session 5. In earlier sessions, we have come to know about Mr. Vipin Chaudhary and how he met with Mr. Parimal Ghosh, who had given him information about his trip to Ranchi. He said about his staying in bungalow. He told about his intimate thing, like his wife's death 10 years ago, his brother's death due to mental illness, and he said about his fall at Hydro waterfall, and how did he spend his days in Ranchi for a week. But Mr. Vipin Chaudhary never or could not recall the incident that happened in Ranchi. He said again and again that he never visited to Ranchi in 58, as he was in Kanpur with Mr. Bakshi. But he could not confirm with Mr. Bakshi, as he was in Japan with his wife and his new address was not given to Mr. Vipin Chaudhary. Mr. Parimal Ghosh had said that Mr. Mukherjee was there with Mr. Vipin Chaudhary. So he tried to confirm with Mr. Mukherjee. Over the phone, Mr. Mukherjee has confirmed their visit to Ranchi. Now Mr. Vipin Chaudhary is very disturbed. He had a feeling of losing his memory. He knew if there is some head injury, memory is lost. But how is it possible that each and everything, each and every detail he knows except that particular incident, that Ranchi trip. So when he was there at home, his friend Mr. Chunilal, school friend, came to meet him, and he told his servant to say to Mr. Chunilal that it's not possible for Mr. Vipin to meet him for several weeks. But then he realized that Chunilal was the person who can confirm his visit to Ranchi, because Chunilal had a good memory. So what did he do? He asked Mr. Chunilal about his Ranchi trip, and Chunilal was also amazed, and his amazement was with worry. He just asked if really Vipin Babu did not remember anything about the Ranchi trip. Now let's see what has happened. Chuni sat down on the sofa, fixed Vipin Babu with a long hard stare and said, "Vipin, have you taken to drugs or something?" Now he said, "Ki tumne, have you taken some drugs that you have forgotten that Ranchi trip?" "As far as I know, you had a clean record where such things were concerned. You remember everything, so why have you forgotten that Ranchi trip? I know that old friendships don't mean much to you, but at least you had a good memory. Now here there is a he just accusing him that old friendship don't mean much to you. You haven't yet helped me. I came to you again and again for the job, but you haven't yet helped me, and you have told me that you can do nothing for me. That means old friendship don't mean much to you. But what about your memory? You have such a sharp memory. You can't really mean that you have forgotten about the Ranchi trip. So what have you taken? Have you taken some drugs?" Now Vipin Babu had to turn away from Chuni's incredulous stare. Now stares straight into the eyes of Mr. Vipin Chaudhary. Chunilal was saying all these things, and Vipin Babu had to turn away from that stare. "Do you remember what my last job was?" asked Chunilal. "Of course, you worked in a travel agency. You remember that, and you don't remember that it was I who fixed up your railway booking for Ranchi?" "What?" Chunilal said. "You remember my last job, that it was in a travel agency, and you have forgotten that I booked your tickets for Ranchi?" Now, incredulous disbelieving. "I went to the station to see you off. One of the fans in your compartment was not working. I got an electrician to fix it. Have you forgotten everything?" See, in the compartment, even what happened, Chunilal was trying to say so that he can recall those incidents, but Vipin Babu was without any clue. "What is the matter with you? You don't look too well, you know." Vipin Babu sighed and shook his head. I have been working too hard, he said at last. For last 25 years, I have been working so hard that something has happened to my mind. Now I have started forgetting the things. Now he has really become very worried. That must be the reason. Must see about consulting a specialist. Now you should take some rest. Go and consult a specialist. Doubtless, it was Bipin's condition which made Chunila leave without mentioning anything about her job. Now, that time Chunila didn't ask about that job, Bipin Babu had seen some job for him or not. Because Bipin Babu's condition was really very alarming and he needed some medical help. Paresh Chanda was a young physician with a pair of bright eyes and a sharp nose. See, here Mr. Satyajit Ray had described, has given the name and description of the person together. He has now introduced a physician, Mr. Paresh Chanda. What was his specialty? He had a pair of bright eyes and a sharp nose. He became thoughtful when he heard about Bipin Babu's symptoms. Now he also started thinking about this, what had happened to Mr. Bipin Babu. How it is possible that he has forgotten Ranchi trip and he has remembered where Chunilal worked last in travel agency. How is it possible? So he was also very thoughtful. He became thoughtful. Now must see about consulting. Here may have to consult. Look, Dr. Chanda, said Bipin Babu desperately. You must cure me of this horrible illness. I can't tell you how it's affecting my work. Now this horrible illness, that forgetfulness, it's a mental disease, it's a horrible illness. Dr. Chanda shook his head. You know what, Mr. Chaudhary, he said, I have never had to deal with a case such as yours. Frankly, this is quite outside my field of experience. See, physician has come and he is saying his condition is the first condition he has seen in his medical career. And so it is outside of his field of experience. But I have one suggestion. I don't know if it will work, but it's worth a try. It can do no harm. Bipin Babu leaned forward anxiously. What that? As far as I can make out, said Dr. Chanda, and I think you are of the same opinion, you must have been to Ranchi. But due to some unknown reason, the entire episode has slipped out of your mind. Now what he is saying, Kisi, what I have understood, make out means I have understood, and I think you also have the same opinion, ki you must have been to Ranchi. Ab gaye jarur ho Ranchi. You must have been to Ranchi. But due to some unknown reason, the entire episode has slipped out of your mind. That is lapse of memory. What I suggest is that you go to Ranchi once again. See, if memory is lost, doctors also always suggest go to the same place and just try to recall the things. There is a possibility that you will regain your memory. So he is suggesting you go to Ranchi once again. The site of the place may remind you of your trip. This is not impossible. More than that, I cannot do at the moment. Right now, this is the only curing thing I can suggest you. I am prescribing a nerve tonic and a tranquilizer. Tranquilizer that will soothe your mind. Sleep is essential. Sleep is essential. Or the symptoms will get more pronounced. You will have to take complete rest. Sleep is very important. So tranquilizer I am giving you. So you take as much rest as you can. Otherwise, this symptom will be very pronounced. Bipin Babu felt somewhat better the next morning. After breakfast, he rang up his office, gave some instructions and then procured a first class ticket for Ranchi for the same evening. Now procure to acquire or obtain. So, what have we learned? Mr. Bipin Babu has some serious loss of memory. situation, Dr. Chanda, Paresh Chanda has confirmed. And what was his suggestion? He suggested Mr. Bipin Chaudhary to go to Ranchi, go to the same place so that he can regain his memory. So here you are seeing Mr. Bipin Babu, as Chunilal has suggested him to consult a specialist, he has done so, and according to the physician, he is following his instructions and he has booked a first class railway ticket for Ranchi. Let's see what happened in the next slide, whether he will regain his memory or not. In the next slide, we will meet again in the next class. Till then, enjoy the story. Thank you.